can't keep on living like this.
For 12-year-old Lauren Milgram, it's just that simple. No more guns, certainly not in school. And tomorrow in Washington, D.C., she'll make her voice heard. For Lauren, this is personal. 5.5 years ago, she was in her first grade classroom when a gunman opened fire in her school, Sandy Hook Elementary in Newtown, Connecticut. By the time it was over, the shooter had fired at least 150 shots, taking the lives of 20 children, first graders and kindergartners, as well as 6 adults. Lauren's quick-thinking teacher hid all 15 of her students in a tiny bathroom off the classroom, saving all of their lives and her own. Today, Lauren and that teacher are still friends.
Do you feel like you're closer to her, you know, because of everything? I mean, yeah. You really have a nice friendship.
I mean, an experience like this, it really does bring people together.
The March for Our Lives will be bringing people together, too. It was organized by the students of Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. Lauren will stand with them to say enough.
I'm marching because I don't want this to happen to any other child, and it really shouldn't have happened, and that we really do need more safety.
Do you feel like you can make a difference even at age 12?
Yeah. I mean, it's amazing what the Parkland students are doing. Like, they're already so ahead in this generation, and it's just at that age, it's like incredible. Like, they're making such a big difference.
She doesn't talk much about the shooting at her school, but she hasn't forgotten it, nor has she forgotten the many friends she lost that day. One who was killed, Daniel Barden, had given her this heart necklace. She wears it some days and thinks of him. All these years later, her father still recalls gathering with other families at the firehouse, imagining the worst.
When I look back, that was the families of the 20, or the 26 really, you know. Those adults were lost that day too.
Lauren's parents and her brother Dalton will be marching alongside her. Dalton was in the 4th grade and survived the Sandy Hook shooting too.
When you saw what happened in Parkland, what did you think?
I mean, there have been so many. I mean, it's almost desensitizing to just see one every so often.
So it's time to change.
100%, yes.
We can make a difference. We can speak out. This makes us feel like we're doing something when we do go out and we march and we do something together as a family.
Our kids, sadly, you know, we're not old enough to speak out. And we as parents, I won't say we failed them, but we were too polite. These Parkland kids, they will not be silenced. They will not be muzzled.
Nor will his own daughter, who still has hope that gun laws will change in her lifetime.
Do you think guns are just too easy to get in this country?
Yes, definitely.
Would you want your teachers to be armed?
Of course not. Like, that's just a horrible idea. I mean, any child would be able to pick up a gun and they could shoot it thinking that it might be just some sort of toy.